Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today I have another products I'm glad I didn't buy video. So I like filming these every couple of months so we can look back on a few makeup items that kind of caught my attention that I decided to pass over for one reason or another. And I look back and I'm not too sad to have missed out on these, and I'll tell you why in this video. I like to do these because this is a practice that I like to do myself when I'm interested in a new makeup product. By the way, there's a train going by. It has been going by forever, so if you hear squeaking in the background, that is a train. But I like to give myself some time to just kind of pause and think about whether I actually want something before I just jump on it and buy it. And this was a technique that I mentioned in my How to Stop Buying So Many Palettes video, which I'll leave linked down below if you missed that. And in that video, I said I like to give myself maybe a month or a couple weeks and still just kind of marinate over an item, and then if I still want it after that time period, that's a sign that I really want it and I'll probably get a lot of value from it. But a lot of times after a month, I've kind of forgotten about it, and that's what happened with most of these. So let's go ahead now and hop into it. If you're interested in this makeup look, I did just film it. It was a Chatty Get Ready With Me. I'm using these two palettes. It is up already and I will leave it linked down below. So this first one I have Lauren May Beauty to thank, and I'm gonna leave a video that she posted linked down below where she went through her collection to look for grayscale eyeshadows and products. And watching her video made me realize I didn't need this even though I really wanted it. This is the Lime Crime Immortalis palette, and it is beautiful. I would say this and the Smoke Show palette are like my cool tone dreams, but watching Lauren's video really taught me that I have a lot of these shades. Let me scoot over so you can see the photo. And I've definitely continued to be inspired by this color story, which is what I think is so beautiful and fantastic about makeup. And without having to buy this, I've really been able to draw inspiration from it. So that's kind of been the route I've taken. I decided not to get it. I mean, right now, who knows? Who knows what will happen in the future? I'm not speaking to the quality of any of these products because they're probably all amazing. I'm just saying I don't need them because I have something similar. Next is the ColourPop Kathleen Lights So Jaded palette. And this is one that I was definitely feeding into the hype of. So many people were discussing this and raving about it and giving it great reviews. And I really enjoy the ColourPop eyeshadow formula. Surprisingly, I only have one of their palettes, but I've purchased many, many singles from ColourPop, and I really love the formula, so I don't doubt that I would get use out of this, and it's probably something I would enjoy. But do you want to know the main reason I talked myself out of it? It's just too big, and I've told you guys recently that my eyeshadow drawer is really starting to spill over. It's getting a little too crammed. That's why I've decluttered a few more eyeshadows in recent videos, and I need to be really critical about the eyeshadow palettes I'm bringing in because I just don't have room in that drawer. And like I've said before, that's kind of the way that I like to keep myself in check. Once I can't close that drawer, something's got to change. I need to either declutter, buy less, whatever it is, I want to keep it contained within that drawer. So for me to buy a palette this big is really going to make it challenging for me to keep that drawer not from overflowing. So it's too many shades. I have a lot of them. It's beautiful and it's fun, but I just didn't need it. All right, this next one I thought was so stunning, and this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Carly Bible palette. Now, the main reason that I decided not to purchase this is because I started seeing some rather so-so reviews on it, and I do think the reviews have been mixed. I've seen some people who really enjoy it, but for me, the shades that were drawing me in the most were those silvery blues and the purple, and those are the shades that I'm hearing the most mixed feedback on. A lot of people are saying, okay, well, the rest of the palette's quite good, but these shades aren't the best. And for me, I would be buying the palette basically for those shades. So if those are the ones that are duds, I definitely don't need it. And I grabbed this. I definitely do not think this is a dupe, but this is the color story that I find similar, at least within my own collection. This is the Sigma Enchanted palette, and it has a lot of those purpley silver tones. And for me, I love this and get so much use out of it that I knew I could skip over the Carly Bible one. Now, the ColourPop Disney Designer Collection. You guys may or may not know that I used to work in Disney World, so I have a soft spot in my heart for anything Disney themed, and instantly I'm drawn to it and intrigued by it. I love princesses. I love that this collection really highlighted some of the princesses that we don't see as much. It wasn't the same ones we get in every collaboration. And like I've said, the packaging, or not packaging too, I guess, but I was gonna say the quality of ColourPop always impresses me. There have been very few products from ColourPop that have let me down. Like, the quality is there, but I can't buy everything. They release a ton. So this was one of them that, while I was really into the packaging and the idea of it, there was nothing in it that I needed. And is anything in this collection different or unique from things I already have? Not really. It's just the cute Disney packaging, and that's not really enough of a reason to buy something, especially when I have the collection that I do. Maybe if I had like one highlighter and I wanted to buy one of these Disney highlighters because I love the princess on it, sure, but I have too many to be buying things just because they're cute. And the final one I'm a little nervous to talk about, the Tati Beauty palette, okay? I think it's really pretty, and to be honest, what she did with this, I think, is pretty unique. I mean, the color story is one that we've seen before, but the idea of having each of these tones in different textures, I thought was really fun and quite unique. But this is another one I've kind of seen so-so reviews on, and a lot of people are saying that they're getting a lot of glitter fallout, which for me, I don't love that. And I have a lot of like single glitters that I never use, so I don't know why I would look at this and think, oh, I would totally use those glitters all the time. I have like liquid glitters from Stila and Pixi and other brands that don't give me a ton of fallout that I don't use. That are easier to use even. So I'm like, I know if I don't use the easy version, I'm not going to use the difficult version. And while I think what was done here was really unique, it's not, again, something that I don't have. So I know a lot of people have been loving on this palette. I'm really excited for Tati and this launch and to continue to watch out for her brand and their upcoming launches. But for this one, I decided to pass on it. But I want to hear from you guys. Did you pick up any of these products? Do you love them? Because as I said in the video, I think if I would have purchased any of these, I don't think they would have been duds. I don't think I would have hated them, but I just didn't need them. And that's kind of the basis of this video, that I was able to kind of talk myself out of them, wait a little bit, and I would stop thinking about them. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know down below again if you purchased any of these and what your thoughts are. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.